Today I feel like making a vegan three-course meal and I thought I would show you exactly how I do it. It's all going to be plant-based, it's all going to be very delicious, and we are going to make a starter, which is going to be crispy broccoli with a cheesy sauce. Then we'll make some quick vegetable spaghetti for the main course, and finally we are going to make the most exceptional no-bake peanut butter cheesecake for the dessert. And I am so excited for all of these recipes, and if you want to follow along and also make a three-course meal, then you're more than welcome to do that, or you can make these as one-off recipes. It's entirely up to you. Regardless, you need to try these out. Also subscribe, because I make lots of vegan food and I teach you how to do it as well, without any fuss, without any complicated ingredients, and without compromising on any flavor. Okay, we are going to start off making the batter for the cauliflower, which is going to use some chickpea flour. You can substitute ordinary flour if you want, but I would recommend using chickpea because it does helps to make the flavor better. Then I'm going to add nutritional yeast. Then for spices, I have paprika, curry powder, and turmeric. And finally, some plant-based milk. And now whisk everything together. Now I'm just going to line a baking tray with parchment paper. And here I have some broccoli florets. That's really difficult to say. What I'm going to do is I'm going to first of all dip these in the batter. And then I also, basically, I added some gluten-free oats to a blender and just pulse them very roughly. So it's kind of half of an oat flour structure, and then I have some whole oats remaining in there. And basically this is a really good alternative to breadcrumbs that's also gluten-free. And I usually would use gluten-free breadcrumbs for a recipe like this, but I know they can be quite difficult to find, so I wanted to give you guys an alternative. So you just grab your broccoli and dip it in the chickpea flour batter, followed by the oats. Proceed to lay all of them out on the baking tray. And you just want to proceed to bake this at 180 degrees Celsius, which is 350 Fahrenheit, for around 25 to 30 minutes. Okay, now we're going to make the sauce, and to start with, we will add a block of extra firm tofu. Up next, we have coconut milk, lime juice, a couple of cloves of garlic, salt, and cornstarch. Firstly, I'm going to prepare an onion. So to this frying pan, I am going to add some cooking spray, the onion. I'm also going to add tomato paste. Now I'm going to add the rest of the vegetables. as well as cumin and paprika. And you basically just want to continue cooking the vegetables for a good 7 to 10 minutes, just until they've softened completely and until the spices get nice and fragrant. Now I'm going to add plant-based milk and some tamari. Now I'm going to add spaghetti, which I'm going to transfer straight from the pan that I was cooking it in. Nutritional yeast for a cheesy flavor. Some freshly squeezed lime juice. I love adding green peas to pasta and noodle dishes as a finishing touch. I'm going to start by making the base for the cheesecake. And first of all, I have some walnuts in here, which I'm going to add to a food processor. Now I'm going to add oats. You can use gluten-free or regular. Here I have maple syrup. You can use any liquid sweetener of your choice. Coconut oil. And just a little bit of vanilla extract. To make the cheesecake layer, we will start with cashews, which I soaked for an hour. Then I'm going to add peanut butter for the peanut butter flavor. Next, I have some more maple syrup, coconut oil, some lime juice, or you can use lemon juice if you wish, and some coconut milk. Well, there we have it, my friends, the most spectacular vegan three-course meal. We have the quick and easy vegetable spaghetti, then we have the crispy broccoli, and of course, no-bake cheesecakes with a delightful chocolate cake, because you just can't go wrong with chocolate. And you should definitely get all of these on your weekly menu as soon as possible. They're all vegan, gluten-free, plant-based goodness.